Hey guys, welcome back to this video. We're gonna paint this wave here. And here we start with the pre-sketch, just to establish the rough shape. This here is the reference material, and this is the palette I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use titanium white, lemon yellow, lamp black, and phthalo blue for this underpainting here. You see, I put in the colors pretty thick, not allowing the white to shine through. And I already also built up the whole shape of the wave here. And this is the part of the reference material that we start with. As you can see, I take a smaller brush, flat brush, and start to build up the single waves, but pretty rough and pretty just to get in the shape, more or less. Now I take a smaller brush and lighter color and start to build up the details on the waves here. You know, I establish where I will put in the reflections. And now that this is clear, I start to thin down the color even more and start to build up the final details. So this is basically the way I build up waves. I go in with the broader brush, establishing the base form of the waves, and then I get finer and finer and thin down the colors even more and start to establish the final details that you need to put in. And this is call it a dry brush technique, a wet one, whatever, but this way it's much easier to build up this whole thing. Of course, I follow the reference material and I just try to build up this whole scene in a realistic way. Sometimes getting even thinner of a color down, some lighter tones, some darker tones. It takes a while, but when you follow the reference material that you have, then you should be able to follow it pretty easily. You don't have to copy it, but take it as a guidance, I would say. And so it takes a while. Build up this whole thing. Now the background is finished and now I start to build up the upper part of the wave here. And you see I'm using a pretty thin down color so that I have the background shining through, and this makes the whole thing, the whole water, believable. Goes here. I basically paint the water on the outside and leave the middle free, more or less. Let the background shine through, and with this we are able to establish the appearance of the clear water here. I need some more details here, as you can see. Very fine brush. Now we start to build up the whitewater section. And yeah, the trick here is to also use the dry brush technique and to get rid of these sharp edges in most of the places. And some some places you have to put in, like here for example, the harsher lights, a harsher color. So there we have these color reflections in from the sun. You know, I build up the foam in the shadowy part. Also with a dry brush technique. And the key here is to thin down the color on the brush even more when it comes to painting the white water on the backside. Less color on the brush means that the white water appears to be even more in the shadow. Here now I build up the centerpiece of this painting here, the crashing wave. We have a reflection on the upper side here. And I build up this whole process slowly. Those tiny brushes, as you can see. And already here you can see that the dark color on the upper part is basically the color that we have behind this part of the border. We have in the upper part basically showing this clear water thing. And the same goes for this part here. You see, I build up this darkness, darker colors here, step by step, working with darker colors for the background, and putting on these lighter foam water colors here. And this is basically a process that you have to adjust constantly. Going in a bit darker here and there, and seeing, okay, this was a bit too harsh, then blending. And you see that I build up this whole thing not in just one rush, but I basically start to build it up gradually. And here now I put in the darkest colors on the right side, where I want to have the water to appear to be not there. The same goes here. Basically, the thinner the water gets, the more you need to put in the colors from the background. And the background color, as you can see here, is this darkish, grayish, blackish color here from the background. And if you do this, then the water or the wave appears to be transluctant, transparent. Put in some white water foam parts here, the upper part. I'm building this whole thing up even more. Some more white water, some more finer details. And here, also on the lower part. And don't forget the details, very important. Here I build up the white water in the shadowy part. This is the same technique, dry brush and very soft in some places, and some places a bit more harsh, like here, a bit more edgy. And I also have lots of variations in size of this white water. Some very fine parts, some very rough parts, thicker parts, more bigger parts. And that's what we have to include to make this thing look realistic. Adding finally some more final details here. So I'm gonna step close and this thing really pops out. And then we're basically finished. If you'd like to see more wave painting tutorials, I got here another one.